say, man, I don't give a fuck about the feds, DEA, ATF, task force, jump out boys, or your local neighborhood robbers, baby. I got to keep on pushing.
Baby, don't do
this
that.
This who y'all want?
Baby.
This who y'all want? Betty Boop, huh? This who y'all want, huh?
Don't do that.
This who y'all want, huh?
Baby, don't do
this
that.
This who y'all want, huh? On live, huh?
Don't do that.
Bitch, get the fuck out of my face. This what y'all want, huh? Huh?
My
bitch,
kids,
I told you.
My kids,
I told y'all I was going to embarrass you. I don't give a fuck. Fuck your
nothing.
Kids, bitch, because you don't give a fuck about me, bitch. This what y'all
it.
Want, huh?
I
this what y'all want, huh? Betty Boop, huh?
I did
a nigga being loyal to you.
I have
send
it.
Me money.
I promise.
Doing everything I supposed to do.
I have not did.
Still talking to these niggas? Huh? You still have a conversation, huh?
No.
Tap in.
No.
This what y'all want. This y'all hoe? Tap in, nigga. Yeah, Frederick. Tap in, nigga. Y'all want her? Huh? Tap in. I'm about to embarrass the fuck out you. I been sending this bitch money.
Doing
everything I supposed to do. And you got niggas up here sending me money. Say hi.
I didn't do nothing.
Say hi, bitch.
I didn't do it.
Say hi.
I didn't do
nothing. Say hi, hoe. Say hi. I'm gonna embarrass the fuck out you.
I didn't mean to hurt
say hi.
You like that, but I ain't did.
Say
nothing.
Hi, nigga.
I ain't did nothing.
Yeah, boy.
I ain't did
slaying like that, nigga.
I ain't
huh? Y'all want up? Send this hoe money. All type of shit. She up here talking to you. Fuck, nigga.
I did
who
do
ain't doing shit.
Shit
for her? Who ain't doing shit for her, nigga? You niggas ain't doing shit for her.
I haven't did nothing.
Yeah, I know, bitch. I was about to take you to the mall and go shopping.
I
bro.
Ain't did nothing.
Fuck out of here.
So, what we have here is a woman in duress who's being menaced by her live-in partner or a lover or a husband. I don't know who he is or whatnot. I think it's just a boyfriend, and he's extremely emotionally distraught, and he's verbally and physically terrorizing this woman and shit. And he's doing it because he believes she's cheating on him, and he feels betrayed. And he's given her umpteen amount of dollars. And, you know, he sees himself the way she sees him. His worth is his wallet, you know. And he's taking it to extremes and whatnot. And he doesn't look to be in the best of shape. And he's somewhat feral. He's almost like a wild man with his crazy hair and his bare chest with tattoos and hair on it. And, you know, it just looks like a crazy man and whatnot. So he's made for proxy violence, whatnot. Some race soldiers could just show up and light him up, and no problem, okay? Nobody's gonna be pursuing him and shit, as far as we know, you know. So I'm just saying, here you go. This is what we call a classic pookie. This is a dangerous guy, you know. This is a guy that, you know, she picked, all right. And this is a teachable moment and shit because she picked this guy. She laid up with this guy. She had some kind of relationship with this guy and it's backfired in her fucking face. But these days you would just hear females, you know, lambasting black men for all kinds of things that we have no fucking control over. We cannot control what this woman does in her private life, who she picks to lay down, open her legs up with, who she has kids with, what she does with her fucking body and shit. We can't control that shit, nor should we, all right, nor should anyone. You know, we're not afforded that same courtesy and shit to speak our truth, you know. You guys would even make a joke out of me saying that and shit, you know. So fucking sad, your mental illness. But who's at fault here? Who's really, when you look deep in past Pookie, who looks, you know, in that last still, almost looks like a fucking Bigfoot or something. You know, who's really at blame here and shit? This crazy motherfucker or the woman that gave him a chance to do all this shit, and he made very good use of this shit. You know, for many years, you know, I had to, you know, in the past I've had somewhat of a white knight mentality, not so much these days or whatnot when you look at the forest for the trees and shit. This is pretty fucked up, man. It's pretty fucked up. This guy's a feral individual. He doesn't even look human and shit. Look like he's fighting, he's look like he's spiritually on fire and shit. And he's just irritated and shit. And this female sitting up putting up with this shit because she thinks it's what she deserves. And maybe it is what she deserves because she looked at this guy and she decided to make a life porn out of him. And this is the same kind of female you'll see sitting up making these goddamn divested videos and talking shit And that guy will still be in the fucking house while she's talking all that shit behind closed doors or in her car on a fucking phone or something, okay? Yeah, this is what's behind all that bullshit, okay? Your bad choices and shit. Why don't you take some fucking accountability? This female needs to take some fucking accountability after she inevitably calls the cops and they end this motherfucker, or he ends her or shit. Or he does some other crazy shit, you know? Despite what he's actually doing or not, you can see that he's extremely emotionally distraught and hurt because he feels betrayed and shit. And so he acted out like a female. He wants to stoop to her level and, you know, do some interpersonal shit to try to embarrass her to potential suitors and shit by revealing himself. He knows his self-esteem is so low that he knows them visually seeing him in his disheveled state alongside her will make her less appealing to other suitors in his mind and shit. But those other Pookies, those other Tyrones and Ray Rays out there, they don't give a shit as long as she bend over. Alright, that's all they care about. She bend over and look at their headboard and shit. Let them handle their business. And that's what's going to happen. It's just a vicious cycle repeating itself. You know, there's been much made about the talk of a certain bald eagle, a humanoid bald eagle, talking about, you know, aborting black babies and shit. And, you know, fuck, man. You know, what's the use of doing that when you guys keep repeating a vicious cycle of bad choices? This has been a teachable moment.